I want to bring in senior climate scientist and the director of climate science at the Union of Concerned Scientists, Brenda Ekwurzel. It's good to see you again. Thank you for coming back to the program. What do you see when you watch these pictures coming out of Hawaii?
Well, first of all, the combination of the incredible winds from the Hurricane Dora, 60 miles per hour, fueling intense wildfires, it makes it very, very difficult for people to get out of harm's way. So everyone who's experiencing this, my heart is just, it's really hard to watch these pictures.
How are the fires that we're seeing in Hawaii right now different than what we see in other parts of the country? We know they're different from what we've seen in Hawaii in years past.
Yes, it's unprecedented in the way that was said. The combination of changes in land use, also the changes in the drying out. Tropical forests around the world are not getting the same amount of precipitation, and that also is happening on the island of Maui. In fact, 16% of it is in a severe drought, and around another 20% is in moderate drought. So these drought conditions, not getting the same amount of rain by former La Niñas that used to give rain, they don't give as much rain anymore. The rain systems are passing a little off axis, so they're not getting the rain. So these drying conditions, warmer atmosphere because of climate change, and then you add a hurricane winds that are far away, Category 4 Dora on Tuesday, and 60-mile-per-hour winds in the Maui era. This is a lethal combination that really we need better computing power at the National Weather Service. We need more investment in that last mile of communication so people who are making their own decisions, we have better systems for letting people understand where it's safe to go and much greater warning for people who don't have as much ability to get out of harm's way than fully able-bodied people. We have to get further in advance of this.
You know, to your point of what's still needed, the national director of the Green New Deal Network, who also happens to be an indigenous leader in Hawaii, told USA Today this: we need legislation that is bold and urgent as the scale of the wildfires choking Hawaii and Canada, the heat waves suffocating Texas, and the extreme flooding drowning Europe. How much of this was preventable?
You know, we call certain seasons danger seasons. They do not have to be as dangerous if we invest the infrastructure in high power computing power for more advanced convergences of extreme events, such as a hurricane co-occurring with a wildfire in such a region such as Hawaii. These type of convergences are, we also need scientific advances in the research community. We also need social science for how do you better communicate these risks to people who are first and worst going to be feeling the brunt of these changes brought about largely from fossil fuel burning and cement manufacture and the changing world, the landscape use changes we've been making, as you mentioned at the top, about decades in the making. These are known, and we have to get better at understanding how they combine to be a very unprecedented event.
Brenda Ekwurzel, good to have you on the program again. Thank you so much.